Szanowni Państwo, dzień dobry, witam bardzo serdecznie podczas drugiego dnia.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the second day of the Autoglass seminar. We're talking about a vehicle glass only. It might seem that this is something that is used for us to see the world only, but today actually we are going to talk about the whole vehicle. We're going to discuss how much what we do to any part of the vehicle to impact the glass. We are also going to look into the future. We are going to discuss the directions and the trends that we have on the automotive market. We have Jarek Kuciński with us, the technical manager in Autoglass. Jarek, today we are going to look into the future. We are going to discuss what's happening with the development of technology, because this also impacts the quality of glass, of windscreens. Yes, we're talking about calibration, calibration of systems, calibration of cameras, etc. We are going to discuss all these things today. Well, this is an amazing discovery for me, because when testing cars and looking at what's happening in terms of safety development, I can see that we are moving towards autonomic vehicles. Well, the phenomenon as such already exists. Whether these autonomous vehicles are going to become a permanent element of the automotive sector, we'll see. But anyway, we can see such trends. There are an increasing number of systems that are based on radars and cameras that enable the car to stay in lane without the driver's intervention, and all that impacts the windscreen. Yes, that's true. There are more of us on the roads. We drive faster. The traffic is higher. And that's why we have to focus on what's happening around. And drivers are not always able to do that. And these systems should assist them in noticing everything that should be noticed. Well, this is happening already, and the world is moving in this direction. Yes, of course. Apart from traveling and driving a car, we want to do many other things. I mean, you take a look at your mobile phone, you want to read a book, watch a movie. The system is reading emails to us, and we are still driving a car. So we need to compensate for the loss of driver's attention. All right, so what are we going to discuss today? We are going to look at the systems. We are going to discover what calibration is all about. So before we listen to our first very interesting lecture, let's discuss what calibration is. Well, each system requires some servicing. The system related to cameras and radars, sensors, needs to be fine-tuned. I actually compare that to a sniper. We can see the guy lying down on the roof, for example, and trying to shoot the purpose. Taking into account the ambient conditions, the wind, etc., etc. And the same is happening to the vehicle. Once we replace tires, for example, or replace the windshield, the cameras may not be looking exactly in the direction that they should be looking at. So what I am concerned about, and I have to share this thought with you, we as drivers have to bear in mind that each system is, well, based on technology, and that we may have high-end technology, but still the technology may fail. I still have limited confidence in such systems. I mean, on the one hand, they are amazing, they improve safety. But on the other hand, I can't imagine the situation in which the driver can lose attention. Well, this is the purpose of these systems. They should compensate for the loss of attention of the driver. And calibration serves the purpose of checking whether the systems operate efficiently. Well, yesterday we were talking about glass repair. We were discussing what's happening when the damage is made. So let's say that I damaged the windscreen. I went to your shop. You repaired it. Well, we could have repaired it, we could have replaced it, but no matter whether we are talking about the replacement, we need to recalibrate the systems, the ADAS systems. When the windscreen is replaced, the calibration is absolutely necessary. Like with the sniper, you have to aim correctly. Yes, if the system is not working properly, then the car may leave the lane, for example. Well, if you change the tires, for example, or the pressure in the tires changes, whatever we do with the suspension system, requires calibration. Even if the angle changes by a slight part of a degree, then the camera will see differently. If the pressure in the tires changes, probably the camera's view will move up, so it will look further. And the calculation of the distance made by the ADAS system will be wrong. And the car may not start braking at the right time. Yes, so we need to use your imagination, and you have to realize that different things may happen. If the system has not been properly calibrated, driving may be dangerous. So now we're going to take you into the future. We're going to take you on a journey with our excellent specialist, to whom you listened yesterday, Eddie Irving. I've read a lot of his statements. He knows a lot about the automotive industry, and he specializes in those systems that make roads safer. But he's also going to talk a lot about calibration and about what to do with the systems and about the future of the automotive. Eddie Irving.